So our discussion for today is the disadvantage of non-renewable energy sources on how it affects the world around us. Like, for example, some groups of First Nations oppose the purpose pipelines because they believe it infringes on their rights.
I mean, but does it really matter, though? I mean, I don't get why everyone makes such a big freaking deal out of that. Native opposes literally everything, and it's not like they actually have to care. They don't work for their money.
Here we go again.
Look, all I'm just saying is, why does it matter so much? If it was truly their land, wouldn't there be like a paper that said so on it?
Well, that's the part of the issue. Most First Nations land was forcibly taken from them. In many ways, that's exactly the problem in BC. There weren't any treaties signed by Indigenous people. That means there was no legal standing between the government taking the land and the Aboriginal people willing to letting it go.
If it was their land, they would still be living in longhouses right now. Canada wouldn't even be a first world country. Like, I get that some of it sucked, but it helped them in the end. Like, they wouldn't be able to read or whatever without the help they got.
Adam, what happened to them isn't concern help. They were there to learn. They were there so they could be white, you dumb hippo.
So what, playtime? Now we have to pay them all our taxes for something we didn't even do. They're basically stealing from us, and they don't deserve any from it. We're the ones who pay for the warfares and their booze, and they do absolutely nothing. And we learn about them all the time, Mr. Baldi. We get it. We know what a residential school was. It was a school for natives. And then they go on and on and on like it matters or something. If they were one in-
Hey Adam, can you shut up and stop being a freaking racist person over there? God, you're like one of the most annoying person in this classroom!
Oh Jeremy, don't freaking go there. Just because you say I'm the most annoying person in this classroom doesn't make me I'm annoying, okay? You're probably the most annoying person in this classroom because you won't shut up about your freaking missing father. Because, you know, your father, he's freaking dead. So why don't you just shut up, Jeremy, about your father? Who cares if he dies? He died from a freaking African-American or a native person. So what? So shut your freaking mouth.
Oh, you want to go? Is that it? Well, come on. Square up then. Square up with me, dear Adam.
Enough. Enough, you two. That's enough. We will not have fighting in this class. This is a Christian school. And Jeremy, if I hear one more word out of you, you're getting sent to the principal's office. Because this is the second time you've been talking into my class.
What? What about Adam? He's the one who's been saying all this-
Zip it! I do not want to hear another word out of you. We're in class, so shut your mouth, Jeremy! Do you understand?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. I shouldn't raise my voice on you.
Alright, class. Now take out your books and turn to page 57.
I can't believe this.
We're continuing off since page
56. I got in trouble for like stopping Adam for being racist. I mean, frick, he was born in the south of Alabama, and basically his parents are a complete racist too. And now I get in trouble for like defending the class. Are you serious? God, why does Mr. Baldi always act so tough on me? God. He's even worse than the bully!
Hey Jeremy, are you gonna fight Adam again? Come on, he's right over there. He hurts your feelings. Come on, man. Fight him. Fight him.
Just ignore him. Just ignore him, Jeremy. Do not talk back before I get kicked out of this class again for the freaking 180th time for dumb reason, because Mr. Baldi can't really don't like me. Hey Andy, what time do we have do we have rehearsals? Because Miss Jackson said that we're supposed to leave this class really early.
Well, it's almost like 11:30, so we can like go there now before anyone else does for Heather's the musical. Mr. Baldi, may we leave really early because, we have, like, a rehearsal, coming up, and, can we leave this class really early?
Oh, yeah! I was gonna tell you, Charlie and Andy, that Miss Jackson told me that, you guys were supposed to leave really early for rehearsals. So yeah, you may leave really early since you two are basically musical actors. So yeah, you guys are may excuse from this class, and don't worry about the homework.
Thanks, Mr. Baldi. All right, let's go, JD.
And right behind you, Veronica.
I want to die. These guys are like one of the most annoyingest people in class. Oh, we're drama students. Oh my god, Andy and Charlie, I don't care. God, I swear, I really hate drama kids. They are one of the most annoying people in like other classes. Especially when we like learn like the history of Alexander Hamilton. Oh my god, I wanted to die because Charlie and Andy, they would not stop singing the soundtracks out of it. Oh, thank god, they're going to rehearsals. Their own space. Their home. I don't know.
Oh, it looks like the principal thing is having an announcement. So everyone, shush!
Attention all staff and students, and teachers and whatever. There is a crazy white kid with a gun inside the school. He looks about like 19 years old, and he has like an AK-47, and he's like, I don't know, 6 feet tall, but he's heading towards the school. So whatever you do, teachers, lock your doors, and whatever you do, don't let your students get out of the class. Before Mr. Baldi fires you for letting your kids get out of the class and dies. So remember, keep your doors very locked and don't let anyone in until further notice. And also, if you do escape, no running in the halls either, because I will send you for detention for 30 seconds before the shooter kills you. Yeah, I'm really restrictive of running in the halls, thanks to Mr. Baldi. So remember, there is a shooter in the school, so do not escape the school because the shooter will try to kill you. So again, there is a shooter in the school, so keep this place on lockdown for further notice until we get the police get on here on time. So thank you, and I hope you guys survive. Principal Singh's out.
Really? Again? Another crazy white kid in the school? What, a gun? That's great. Well, class, it feels like we have no choice to stay in this class. So remember, do not panic or scream, okay? Because they will hear you guys. So please stay silent. And whatever you do, don't scream.
Shouldn't we go under our desk, Mr. Baldi? Because apparently if we do sit on our desk, this shooter will definitely shoot us.
Jeremy, shut up! There's a shooter outside!
Yeah, Jeremy, do you want us to be all killed?
But yeah, everyone, we'll be fine here. As long as that door was closed, really locked, we'll be fine. But, I am kind of scared, though, but I hope we can, like, stop the shooter at some point.
Oh my god, this is it? Am I really gonna die here? Who's gonna play jump rope on me if I die? Besides, I have no friends, and I'm gonna die alone. Oh my god, this is it for me.
Whoop, if I'm gonna die, might as well I had a good life. Being a racist. Oh well, as long as I'm gonna die out here, I might as well say the N-word. Listen, I love being a bully and all, but whoever's this shooter out there, I hope I didn't bully him. Wait, the principal said he was 19. So I couldn't bully him. Unless he was bullied in high school and was being called a fag and stuff. I don't know. But, it's really scary, and I would never ever do something like this. This is really terrifying. I'd like to hear about a school shooting inside our elementary school. This is really scary, and really scary. What are we gonna do? Oh my god.
So is this it? Am I really gonna die here? I'm gonna freaking die here. Yeah. Some guy's gonna come in here and basically just shoot us all. And I don't wanna die. I can't believe this. I had so much good memories. I mean, my family was never there for me whenever I was in trouble. And Mr. Baldi never liked me. And, like, I have a terrible life. And now I'm gonna die being a terrible, being terrible. Oh my god, this is it. This is it for me.
Whatever happened to those two students, who was in this class?
Well, you did send them out to go to rehearsal. They said that they were going to go to rehearsal, so you sent them out really early.
I'm pretty sure they're dead by now. Adam, it's not funny to say that they're dead. I'm pretty sure they're okay. Probably a teacher probably got them and went to their class or something. So, saying that they're dead is not a funny joke. But I hope they'll be fine.
Oh my god, Mr. Baldi actually done something in his life. By not only hating me, but actually telling his student to stop. Wow. I'm actually surprised that he actually goes up on another student instead of me all the time. Finally. Oh my god! Someone's trying to break in, Mr. Polly. What do we do?
I think I got this playtime.
Hey, the shooter. No one would ever love you if you just leave this school. Go away.
Alright, badass. I'll definitely come in there. As long as they let me shoot you to death, I will leave the school. And I'll kill everybody. Because the school is about to die. And you too, you fat freak!
How do they know I was fat?
Bull, you're such an idiot! You think saying that will make the shooter go away? He will not! He will just kill us all! You freaking idiot!
What did I say about talking, Jeremy?
Hey, Mr. Baldi, why not freaking talk to me or hate me or basically saying to stop talking? Why don't you tell everyone else here in this class to stop talking? And why don't you do something about the shooter? If Bully's gonna say something, why don't you say something and do something to the shooter?
Nobody was even talking in this class, only you. And second of all, you want me to get killed out there?
Pretty much, yeah. I do want you to get killed out there because I completely hate you, Mr. Bully. You are the worst teacher ever, and I wish you were never existed in this first place. Because you're very, very strict with the students, and very mean, and very abusive a teacher, and all you do is just basically slap other students with a ruler. That's basically assault to a minor. You do know that, right?
Well, that was definitely uncalled for.
Fine then! If you guys won't open the door, then I'll open it myself!
What? What does that even mean, Mr. Baldi?
I don't know, playtime. Whatever he's doing out there, he's gonna probably put a bomb through the door. Well, if he tries to get in, I got a weapon too. It's called this.
Oh yeah, a ruler. That would definitely stop the shooter.
Well, it did stop you when I actually slapped you in the forest back in July of 1999.
That was kind of funny, though.
Yeah! He's all ready to Dad?
Bill? Is that... No. No! It can't be!
Yes, Dad. It's me.
What? Are you serious, Mr. Baldi? Your son is a crazy psychopathic white person who's about to kill us all?
This is actually my long-lost son. Before he actually moved when I got divorced. I have not seen Bill in a couple of years after the divorce. Bill, what are you doing here? And why are you doing this? This is not how I taught you back when you were a kid. What happened to the Bill that I used to know? You become a school shooter? What the heck is this?
So that's the reason why you hate me so much.
Why? Why did you leave me with Mom? I told you I wanted to stay with you, because mom was just basically just hurting me. That's the reason why I came to the school, to see if she actually cared. But she didn't. I don't think she would care anyways. Even if I'm dead, I don't even have any friends. Some people would not give her, it would be care, because I knew, they would know I was a psychopath, a cruel, or just a quiet kid. That's all, just a quiet, psychopathic kid. And I was actually planning to kill her anyways. Because you wouldn't understand, Dad. You were never there for me. I wanted to stay with you.
I know. I'm sorry. I'm sorry that I wasn't even there for you. I'm so sorry. Because the reason why is that because your mom gave me a restraining order after the divorce. Because after at court, she was the only one who only has the child, but not me. I'm sorry that I was never there for you or anything, but I couldn't do anything. There was nothing I could do without giving away the restraining order. So I couldn't do anything. So I'm real sorry. I know I failed you as a father. And I know, but killing these students in an elementary school, what's that gonna help? What's that gonna help, Bill? Please tell me, what's this gonna help? By killing these innocent children. Please tell me.
I don't know. I guess if killing these kids would definitely just kill my whole entire childhood. I was planning to kill myself anyways, after I was done killing the kids in here. But no. Because I don't know. It's just been so hard without you. But just mom just basically just beats me up all the time. And basically I've always been bullied a lot, and I've been beating kids up at school. And I'm getting a lot of trouble. It's just real hard. It's real hard. I guess I don't know why I want to kill the kids. I just don't freaking know, Dad. I don't know why. But, Dad, I miss you so much. I missed you for, like, all these years.
Billy, I missed you too.
I missed you, like, every single day. I keep thinking about you and it's been real hard. I missed you a lot. You could stop this. You could just, like, turn yourself in. And then I can, like, release the bail, and then you could live with me. How's that sound? You could live with me instead of your mom. And then it'll be alright. You could just stop and just, like, put the gun down. And we could start all over again. I promise you that. I will do that.
Why don't you just come in here and give your old man a hug? How's that sound?
Sounds good. I'm sorry, Dad. But I have to do this. I ain't going back to jail.
Oh my God!
I'm sorry, Dad. But it's for my own good. I'm so sorry. But it has to be done. I'm not going back to jail after what the frick happened. I'm sorry.
You killed Mr. Baldi. Oh my god. Yes. Oh my god. I mean, I'm kind of happy though, but heck.
Just shut up. Shut the f- up. Just shut up, all of you. You know, it's not easy to have a father, but you know, I had to get rid of him at some point because it's my mother's fault who freaking got a divorce. And now you saw that you're, now you saw me killing your teacher. I'm gonna kill all of you. Hasta Melissa, baby. Who the hell are you?
First prize? Oh my god, you're back? You're back from the dead?
Not just me, who's back alive.
Robot? Are you freaking serious? You gotta be joking. A magic broom? You gotta be joking. Is Harry Potter here in the school? Cause I'll freaking shoot him too. Wait, what the
heck? You attacked Mr. Baldi! Especially the school shooter! Gonna sweep, sweep, sweep up this crazy white trash!
What type of school is this?
Baldi's school's house. What do you think, dummy?
Kid knew it, that they were coming back from the dead after the Y2K.
This is the police! We have you surrounded! Stay on the ground!
It's not fair!
You are watching Life in Story News, where we tell about fake stuff that we don't care. And now, your favorite news anchor, Eli Brookswood.
Good morning, afternight, everyone, and welcome back to the Life and Story News. My name is Eli Brookswood, and we got breaking news, and I cannot wait to share this story because it's actual news this time. Anyways, yesterday, there was a school shooting at the Baldi's schoolhouse that left nobody injured but one killed. But anyways, let's go see what my sister, Rhonda, has to say about this. So tell me, Rhonda, tell me, who is the shooter and who, what gender it is killed?
Well, Eli, it turns out that the shooter has been shot and killed Baldi Maka. And guess who was the shooter? His 19-year-old son, Billy Maka. Yeah, what a freaking plot twist. Anyways, Billy was taken into custody, so anyways, we'll keep this updated.
Actually, Rhonda, I have to stop you right there. We have even more breaking news. We just heard that Billy Maka just escaped from the police county jail of Alabama. If anyone has seen this ugly, disgusting of a human being, this is his face right here. So if anyone sees him, call 911. Anyways, Rhonda, let's go back to you. Did you get any interviews of the school?
Yes, I'm about to. I'm standing here at every hospital in the state, and I'm about to interview some.
So, how do you guys feel about Baldi's death?
Happy.
Sad.
Angry and sad.
He was my only friend, and now he's gone.
It sucks, but oh well. Might as well get a new teacher.
Well, there you have it, people. I got the only interviews out of them. So again, if you do see Billy Maka, call 911 or Crime Stop.
Jeremy, you're getting detention.
What? Why?
You are the only one who doesn't care about Mr. Baldi's death. So you're coming with me. You're staying in detention until the end of year. You should know better. When will you learn? And your parents are gonna hear about this one.
That's what you get, Jeremy! You have no soul! And Mr. Baldi? I'm gonna miss you.
I mean, look at these realistic, state-of-the-art 3D camping graphics.
I'm sorry, Dad.
It's like the real...
I told you. I wasn't going back. And now look what I've done to you. I'm sorry.
Alright, so I'm guessing this is the house right here. It looks pretty old and shit. But yeah, let's go inside and see if we stay tonight.
Ooh, sexy robots. Oh, hello there, pretty robots. How are you all doing today?